जनगणमन अधिनायक जय हे भारत भाग्य विधाता पंजाब सिंध गुजरात मराठा द्राविड उत्कल बंगा विंध्य हिमाचल यमुना गंगा उच्चल जलधि तरंगा तव शुभ नामे जागे तव शुभ आशीष मांगे गाहे तव जय गाथा जन गण मंगल दायक जय हे भारत भाग्य विधाता जय हे जय हे जय हे जय 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 हे
మాన్యశ్రీ శాసన మండలి అధ్యక్షులు మాన్యశ్రీ శాసన సభాపతి గౌరవ శాసన మండలి సభ్యులు గౌరవ శాసన సభ సభ్యులు అందరికీ నా శుభాభివందనములు ముందుగా రాష్ట్ర శాసన సభకు ఎన్నిక అయిన మీ అందరికీ నా శుభాకాంక్షలు 2019 సాధారణ ఎన్నికల తర్వాత ఏర్పడిన కొత్త ప్రభుత్వానికి నా అభినందనలు అందరికీ స్వాగతం సుస్వాగతం సుస్థిరత పారదర్శకత అభివృద్ధిని కాంక్షిస్తూ రాష్ట్ర ప్రజలు విజ్ఞతతో తమ ఓటు హక్కు వినియోగించి ప్రజలందరికీ సేవ చేసే అవకాశం మనకు కల్పించారు ఇట్ ఈస్ టైమ్ ఫర్ ద న్యూ గవర్నమెంట్ టు ఫోకస్ ఆన్ ది ఇమీడియట్ కన్సర్న్స్ సమ్ ఆఫ్ విచ్ ఆర్ ఎ కాన్సిక్వెన్స్ of the state bifurcation and rest are consequences of inept handling of challenges emerged post bifurcation the misutilization of resources both human and physical further compounded the state's misery my government has inherited a near empty treasury calling for a stricter accountable and efficient spending of public money and all attendant resources my government however is confident that it can overcome the problems and ensure a satisfying public service delivery to the citizens of the state at a time when people finding their aspirations unfulfilled during the last 5 years looked for a change to take them forward into the 21st century the new government assumed office carrying hopes of 5 crore population for a better and good governance this new government has a perfect blend of fresh and experienced honorable members in the assembly I once again welcome all the members who will be instrumental in making right policies in the interest of good governance I am confident that they would also uphold the values and cultural heritage of this state my government is committed to uplift the downtrodden and the deprived through a corruption free and inclusive governance amidst pockets of affluence there are segments of population which have been neglected in the past and these groups deserve additional support at this juncture where the problems that arose after the state bifurcation continue to haunt and challenge us even after 5 years the need for concerted efforts is even more imperative this calls for a special and focused drive to bring the vulnerable and neglected groups into the mainstream our efforts to pursue the union government to implement all the assurances and promises mentioned in the Andhra Pradesh Reorganisation Act 2014 on another forums will be on top of our agenda these among others include the special category status to the state expeditious completion of Polavaram project and also supporting the state with necessary additional funds. We request the Union Government to fully compensate for the loss of opportunities due to the state bifurcation, such as the income generation, employment opportunities, loss of premier health and education institutions and social infrastructure. My government is fully committed to fulfill all the promises made to the people of this state. It is encouraging that the process has already been put in motion and the sense of joy and happiness among the public who are desperately looking for a change for the better, is discernible. My government has a clear vision and actionable plans to tackle the problems and deliver on the promises made. This government will revamp the system totally and strive to stand as a model for the rest of the country. My government will adopt a two-pronged approach in this process: bold and effective steps to eliminate corruption and revamp the service delivery mechanism by taking it to the doorstep of the citizen. This process of total revamp to ensure a corruption-free state will involve innovative measures which would turn out to be a role model for other states to follow. Firstly, in contrast to erstwhile rules of governance, my government would place transparency and accountability on a high pedestal. As a lead step in this direction, my government, in its very first move, has restored the general consent to the CBI, permitting it to carry out investigations in the state, which had been withdrawn by the erstwhile government. Secondly, my government believes in total transparency. To ensure this, in a hitherto unheard-of measure, my government has sought the assistance of a judicial commission to look into every sizable tender, even before the tender is floated. To enhance transparency and preempt any scope for corruption, this commission will keep these documents in public domain for a week to get a public feedback. After due diligence, the commission will incorporate the necessary changes and return the tender document for further action. Thirdly, my government will take the path of saturation laid down by the late Dr. Y.S. Rajashekar Reddy Garu while dispensing welfare measures to the eligible without any bearing relating to caste, colour, creed or political affiliation. This will ensure doing away with discretionary power, a perceived source of corruption. Fourthly, my government would put in place measures to ensure that government money is not wasted through inflated tenders. Inflationary tendencies in the award of tenders and contracts will be looked into by a committee of experts and correctives put in place where needed. To this end, reverse tendering will be taken recourse to if needed. This latter approach will be a trendsetter in the country to ensure adherence to proper procedures and effective savings in cost and avoid inflated biddings. My government will take a relook at the delivery mechanism of services. It is proposed to bring into the system of a grama volunteer, where in one volunteer from the same village or ward would be assigned to 50 households to door deliver the various schemes of the government. The same volunteer will also be responsible to convey the grievances of the people in his jurisdiction to the village secretariat. Each grama volunteer will be provided with an honorarium of ₹5,000 per month, and my government will not tolerate any corruption in this system. There will be a call center to make sure that people can register complaint against these volunteers if they face any problem. The CMO will directly monitor this process to ensure 100% transparency and satisfaction. Village Secretariat will be made available for providing accessible governance to the people and ensuring that citizens' request is addressed to within 72 hours. This will provide employment to 10 educated youth. My government will make itself accountable by publicly displaying its manifesto and treating it as a sacred document. It will adhere to its implementation without any deviation. Every department of the government will keep a copy of it to make sure that all promises are delivered. In today's context, one would realize that the ideology of the late Dr. Y.S. Rajashekar Reddy Garu, former Chief Minister of the erstwhile Andhra Pradesh, which essentially centered on focusing governance and exploring ways to help the poor, needy and destitute is perhaps more relevant today than ever. It is in the keeping with this outlook that the incumbent government is evolving an integrated welfare agenda, Navaratnalu. Excuse me. Consisting of 9 themes. The themes are YSR Raitu Bharosa, YSR Arogya Shri, Amma Ori, Free Reimbursement, YSR Pensions, Housing for All Poor, Youth, Employment and Job Creation, YSR Asara, YSR Cheyuta, Phase-Wise Ban on Liquor and Jalayagyam. Effective implementation coupled with robust monitoring, progress monitoring of these themes will be the prime agenda for my government in the years ahead. The scheme comprises 9 welfare themes benefiting different segments of population and cutting across various sectors. Let me highlight these themes in a greater detail as they are going to be the cornerstone of my government's welfare agenda. The top focus of my government would be farmers' welfare. Totally committed to the welfare of the farming community, my government has plans to bring about a transformation in the agriculture sector, which hitherto has suffered to an extent by the unpredictable weather conditions and to a larger extent due to incoherent policies. With about 62% of the population still wedded to agriculture, my government considers that it's primary duty to attend to their interests and well-being. My government is seriously concerned about the farmers who are being exploited in various ways, including supply of spurious seed. My government is planning to set up a state farmers commission to delve deep into the farmer-related issues and bring in reforms. The proposed mission will look into the policy and implementation issues in the agriculture and allied sectors. The much talked about linking of agricultural activities with the MGNREGS stands elusive even today. My government will explore ways and means to evolve a policy that will ensure availability of agricultural labour during the season to bring down the cost of cultivation. As promised, my government will provide ₹12,500 per annum through the YSR Raitu Bharosa to each of the farming household at the time of sowing from 15th of October 2019 from the Rabi 2019 itself, much earlier than the timeline originally envisaged. This will ensure a total fund flow of over ₹10,000 crore directly to the farmers, with nearly 1/5 of this amount helping the tenant farmers who, along with the landowners, are desperately looking for financial assistance and solace. My government is determined to safeguard the interests of tenant farmers without hurting the interests and rights of cultivators and landowners. My government also proposes to provide interest-free loans and free borewells to the farmers. It is planned to provide a rig in each assembly constituency in the state so that farmers can go for borewells free of cost. Providing 9 hours of free electricity in the daytime, supporting the aqua farmers, establishing price stabilization fund with ₹3,000 crore corpus, calamity relief fund with ₹2,000 crore corpus, and establishing a food processing unit in each assembly constituency are a few other farmer-friendly initiatives proposed that need special mention. My government is also committed to revive the cooperative sector, particularly the dairy sector, to providing an incentive of ₹4 per litre to the farmers who supply milk to the cooperative dairies. To stand by the farmers' family when in distress, my government is committed to provide an amount of ₹7 lakhs under the YSR Bima scheme in the event of death of a farmer due to any cause. My government is determined to provide assured water to all the districts by taking up integrated water management with conjunctive use of surface and groundwater, development of water resources through scientific water conservation, adopting micro irrigation techniques like drip and sprinkler irrigation, interlinking of rivers, and complete all ongoing projects taken up under Jalayagyam in a time-bound manner. Polavaram, the lifeline of Andhra Pradesh, and other important projects, including the Veligonda project, once conceived as a major project, will be completed in a definite time frame. A third-party inquiry by irrigation and technical experts is also envisaged to set right deficiencies and irregularities, if any. My government, should it find it necessary, will not hesitate to go for reverse tendering after due diligence. The beeping sound of 108 health ambulance vehicle, which of late seems to be in a mute mode, is still etched in our memories. To bring back the past glory and improve the health conditions in the state, my government is determined to ensure preventive, diagnostic and curative health care service delivery to all its citizens through the YSR Arogya Shri. The scheme, which will be applicable to all categories of people whose annual income does not exceed Rs. 5 lakhs, will be effective in all cases whenever the expenditure on health care exceeds Rs. 1000 and will cover an additional 936 procedures to the existing 1095 procedures for treatment. As a special treatment to the persons suffering from chronic kidney problems and diseases like thalassemia, my government will provide a pension of Rs. 10,000 per month. Besides implementing the YSR Arogya Shri scheme effectively, my government will work out a comprehensive action plan to transform government hospitals on par with any private sector facility. All these efforts, while minimizing the out-of-pocket expenses for the poor, will also bring in significant changes in various health parameters like infant mortality rate, maternal mortality rate, anemia among women and malnutrition. To protect the health of the infants, students, pregnant and lactating women in the state, nutrition-related schemes like midday meals will be implemented in the right spirit. To incentivize the village health activists, the monthly honorarium has been increased from Rs. 3,000 to 10,000 to about 45,000 ASHA workers in the state. Alcohol consumption has led to misery and large-scale disruption of families. Realizing the adverse impact of this menace, my government is committed to ban liquor in a phased manner. In a first step, my government has ordered closure of all belt shops. This in itself is expected to bring joy into many hearts. My government is determined to ensure education for all school-going children so that no mother is worried about her child's education. As a token of appreciation and incentive, my government is committed to offer Rs. 15,000 per year to every mother for sending her children to school under the scheme Amaravathi. This act will not only fully eradicate child labour, but also create necessary ecosystem for a knowledge economy through universal education. We are committed to bring about an improvement in the gross enrollment ratio at primary, upper primary and secondary levels, and also significantly bring down the dropout rates at all these levels. The current state of the government schools calls for a huge uplift and relook so that it incentivizes children to attend school. My government is committed to improve the standards and facilities of these schools. My government is fully committed to bear the cost of education for all the poor families. We will provide Rs. 20,000 per year to every student for boarding and accommodation, in addition to full fee reimbursement for students pursuing technical and higher education. My government will also provide quality education in all higher and technical educational institutions. Establishing an inclusive society through YSR Chayuta is our priority. My government is committed to stand by every SC, ST, BC and minority family, and in particular women in the state, by providing necessary support under this scheme. Every woman belonging to these communities and aged between 45 and 60 years will receive an amount of Rs. 75,000 in 4 years at the rate of Rs. 18,750 per year. My government accords top priority for the welfare of SCs, STs, BCs, minorities and other weaker sections. An amount of Rs. 1 lakh will be provided as incentive to brides from these categories at the time of their marriage. My government has plans to set up a permanent BC commission with statutory powers. My government is committed to provide 50% reservation to the unemployed youth of SC, ST, BC and minority communities in all the government's contractual obligations like outsourcing of manpower, transport facilities, civil works, etc. To realize the real inclusive political governance, my government proposes to provide 50% reservation in all political appointments like directors, chairman, trust boards, etc. Financial support will be extended to Nai Brahmins, tailors, fishermen and weavers. My government is equally committed to the welfare of the Kapu community. We have plans to earmark ₹10,000 crores over a period of 5 years for the Kapus. Adequate attention will be given for Aryavaisyas, Muslim minorities, Christian minorities and economically weaker sections in the forward caste. My government is also committed to the welfare of journalists, lawyers and government employees. While corruption or negligence on the part of officials will not be tolerated, my government is open to receiving suggestions which would merit consideration and recognition. Soon after assuming office, in fulfillment of the commitment of raising the social welfare pension to ₹3,000 in a phased manner, my government in a first move hiked the YSR Bharosa pension for old age to ₹2,250, an annual increase of 250 will follow in the coming 4 years, taking the total pension amount to ₹3,000. The age for a person to be eligible for pension has also been reduced from 65 years to 60 years, and this would nearly help another 5 lakh persons. My government is committed to provide a house for every eligible household in the state, irrespective of their caste, creed, religion and political affiliation. We are committed to construct 25 lakh houses in the coming 5 years. Extending support to women, my government is committed to hand over the total outstanding debt amount under Thrift Federation Dwarka in 4 phases directly into the hands of the women. In addition, we will provide loans at 0% interest to all the women entrepreneurs under the YSR Asra scheme. While a fight for special category status, which will provide employment opportunities for the youth in the state, would continue, we are committed to providing employment opportunities to the youth through various other programs. Besides focusing on job creation for youth, both in the organized and unorganized sectors, we will also appoint village ward volunteers catering to 50 households who are willing to serve the village's wards with a monthly honorarium of ₹5,000. These volunteers will act as interface between the people and the government and ensure smooth service delivery of activities identified under the coveted Navaratnalu scheme. My government is also putting in a place Gram Sachivalayam, a village secretariat, which would be present in every village and also to fill in 1.60 lakh vacancies for various posts at the rate of 10 persons per village to work in these secretariats. We are committed to fill in all the vacancies in government offices and also planning to release the calendar of vacancies on 1st of January every year. My government is seriously concerned with providing employment to the youth. Some youth, for various reasons, may not possess the desired education, qualification or skills to secure organized employment. It is essential to handle this vital demographic dividend properly and put them into some economic activity to earn their livelihoods and generate wealth for the nation. A properly trained youth will have better job opportunities. With this perspective, my government is planning to utilize the energies of the youth in a more productive manner. The state is committed to improve the standards in education and bring significant improvement in the ITIs and polytechnics. Ensuring industry linkage with technical education institutions, the youth will be made industry ready. With this, the government will roll out plans to provide jobs for the youth in manufacturing. Besides implementing Navaratnalu in the right spirit, my government will also lay emphasis on developing industry and service sectors. Technology will be adopted in appropriate interventions, especially to ensure safety and security of women. Saturating the rural and urban infrastructure will be taken up in a phased manner. For mitigating the traffic congestion in urban areas, alternative traffic models will be studied. Promoting non-conventional energy and minimizing the T&D losses in conventional power will be given preference. I am happy to mention that the decisions taken by my government in the last 10 days testifies the government's sincerity and commitment towards the delivery of the promises made to the people. The following decisions in particular taken in this direction need mention. Enhancing the pension amount to ₹2,250. Increase of salaries of ASHA workers from ₹3,000 to ₹10,000. Abolition of contributory pension scheme. A committee is to be constituted to work out modalities for the implementation of Amaravathi scheme from 26-1-2020. merger of APSRTC with the government, a committee to be constituted, enhancement of wages of municipal sanitation workers from rupees 12,000 to 18,000, 27% interim relief to employees, enhanced amount to be made payable from July 2019 onwards, implementation of YSR Raitu Bharosa at the rate of rupees 12,500 from 15th October 2019, enhancing the salaries of community health workers in tribal welfare department from rupees 400 to 4,000, enhancement of wages to Anganwadis and home guards, proposal to distribute 25 lakh house pattas from Ugadi 2020 and construction of 6 lakh houses every year for the next 4 years, new sand policy to curb illegal mining and corruption. Chivaraga Supparipalana Andinchadaniki Modalu Pettina Yatra Ipude Modalaindi Manam Ashinchina Marpu 5 Kotla Prajanikam Oka Sampurna Sahakaram Madatone Veelavutundi Kendra Prabhutvam Mariyu Poruga Rashtrala Sahakaramto Na Prabhutvam Dridanishchayamto Munduku Adugu Vestundi Suspashta Maina Praja Tirpunu Dishtilo Unchukoni 5 కోట్ల ప్రజలు ఆశయాలు ఆకాంక్షలు మేరకు వారి కలలు సాకారం చేయడానికి నా ప్రభుత్వం పూర్తిగా కట్టుబడి ఉంది. ఓం సర్వే భవంతు సుఖినః, సర్వే సంతు నిరామయః, సర్వే భద్రాణి పశ్యంతి, మా కశ్చిత్ దుఃఖ భావేత్. ఓం శాంతి శాంతి శాంతి. అందరూ సుఖంగా సంతోషంగా ఉండాలి, అందరూ ఆరోగ్యంగా ఉండాలి, అందరూ ఆధ్యాత్మిక భావన కలిగి ఉండాలి, ఎవరు బాధతో ఉండకూడదు. ఓం శాంతి శాంతి శాంతి. జై హింద్.
జనగణ మన అధినాయక జయ హింద్. భారత భాగ్య విధాత పంజాబ్ సింధు గుజరాత్ మరాఠ ద్రావిడ ఉత్కళ బంగా హిమాచల యమునా గంగా ఉచ్చల జలధి తరంగా తవ శుభ నామే జాగే తవ శుభ ఆశిష మాగే గాహే తవ జయ గాథా జన జన మంగళదాయక జయ హే భారత భాగ్య విధాతా జయ హే జయ హే జయ హే జయ 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 హే.